settle you down. 林碧玲 Miss 贺杰 And we also have three guest teachers. Miss 董秀清 Miss 范南叶 And Miss 任小华
Introducing our honorable judges and guests, let's go over the scoring criteria of this contest.
Yes, our judges will score our contestants' performances from all aspects. The pronunciation and intonation, the synchronization, the individual performance, and their teamwork.
I hope all of the teams can have excellent performances.
Yes, let's give our applause to our contestants and give them our best wishes. Sarissa, what was your dream in your childhood?
Oh, I've been dreaming about to become a princess for
wow,
quite a long time.
A princess? That must be the dream for every little girl.
Yes, but my dream didn't come true. What a pity.
Don't be upset. Because today we have a chance to know what the princess life is.
Yes, they are from CO1, Liu Kang, Xu Liu Ai, Lu Mei Ling, Liang Cai Hong.
Welcome.
I can't wait until she's 18.
Oh, this is a nightmare. I'm going back to bed.
Yeah, the three of us have to talk.
Oh, okay. Is there something else about me and my life that just maybe I might want to know about?
Oh, no.
Are you two waiting to take me on a talk show somewhere to let me know that I have a twin sister who's a duchess?
You have a cousin who's a contessa. Fondly known as Bartholomew, actually we call him Pookie.
Yesterday did not go well. Will you just listen to your grandmother?
Amelia, in a matter of weeks, we have an annual ball. I am hoping that I may present you to the press and the public on that occasion. However, you desperately need some instruction. I speak for the entire Genovian Parliament and the royal family.
And I speak for this family.
Excuse me, I don't have a family with either one of you because you ignored me for 15 years and you lied to me. Families don't do stuff like that to one another, okay?
Where is she going?
The tower.
Mia, you can't run from everything.
She has a tower.
Please, just come down from there. You know, most kids hope for a car for their 16th birthday, not a country.
Just make yourself comfortable.
Oh, this is getting us nowhere. Talk to me. I can't talk to you right now. I'm late for a meeting with my guidance counselor.
I'm late for a meeting with Spain and Portugal.
And what? Mia promises to attend princess lessons until your ball.
It's not my ball. It's Genovia's annual Independence Day ball.
I'm sorry. Mia promises neither to accept nor reject your offer to be royal until this grand ball. And then she makes her decision. Now, can you both live with that?
It seems I have no option.
I have to.
But I want not one word of this until that evening. Is that understood?
Duh.
Or the press would have a field day.
Well, let's not keep Spain and Portugal waiting.
Good evening, everyone. I'm Lydia.
Hi, I'm Miriam's mother.
Hi, I'm Miriam's grandmother.
Okay, let's begin. Well? Well, as always, this is as good as it's gone yet.
I can't want you to be seen.
Oh, this is nightmare. I'm going back to bed.
Mia, the three of us have to talk.
Oh, okay. Is there something else about me and life just maybe I might want to know about? Oh no, are you too waiting to send me on torso to let me know that I have a twin sister who's a duchess?
You have a cousin who's a countessa, formerly known as Bartholomew. Actually, we call him Pookie.
Yesterday did not go well. Would you just listen to your grandmother?
Amelia, in a matter of weeks, we have an ideal war. I am hoping that I may present you to the press and the public on the occasion. However, you desperately need some injunction. I speak for the entire Genovia Parliament and royal family.
And I speak for this family.
Excuse me, I don't have a family with either one of you because you ignore me for 15 years and you lie to me. Families don't do stuff like another, okay?
Where is she going?
The tower. Mia, you can't learn from everything.
She has a tower?
Please, just come down from there.
You know, mosquitoes hope for comfort, they sit in bother, not a country.
Just make yourself comfortable.
Oh,
this is getting us nowhere. Talk to me.
I can't talk to you right now. I'm late for meeting with my guidance counselor.
I'm late for meeting with Spain and Portugal.
I have a thought. Mia promises to attend princess lessons until your ball.
It's not my ball. It's Genovia's annual Independence Day ball.
I'm sorry. Mia promises neither to accept nor reject your offer to be loyal until this grand ball, and then makes her decision. Now can you believe that?
These things I have no option.
If I have to,
but will not one word of this until that even if it's silent soon, the press will have a field day.
Well, let's not keep Spain and Portugal waiting.
Thank you, that's all.
Thank you.
Okay, as we all know, it's always difficult for the first team, but obviously they have given us a standing start, right? As we all know, our English dubbing contest covers various categories. Besides different kinds of movies, we have documentaries and TV plays. The second team will bring us a documentary called Wild China. It is a natural history documentary co-produced by BBC and CCTV. I'm sure they will give us a beautiful and mysterious China from a different way. Let's welcome the second team, Huang Zhihua and Deng Weiping from CO1.
For centuries, travelers to China have told tales of magical landscapes and surprising creatures. Chinese civilization is the world's oldest, and today, its largest. tone to more than 50 distinct ethnic groups. A wide range of traditional lifestyles, often in close partnership with nature. We know that China faces immense social and environmental problems. But there is great beauty here too. China is home to the world's highest mountains. Vast deserts ranging from searing hot to mind-numbing cold. Steaming forests harboring rare creatures. Grassy plains beneath vast horizons. And rich tropical seas. Now, for the first time ever, we can explore the whole of this great country. Meet some of the surprising and exotic creatures that live here. And consider the relationship of the people and wildlife of China to the remarkable landscape in which they live. This is Wild China.
For centuries, travelers to China have paid tales of mighty landscapes and surprising creatures. Distinct ethnic groups and a wide range of traditional lifestyles, often in close partnership with nature.
We know that China faces immense social and environmental problems. But there is great beauty here too.
Vast deserts ranging from searing hot to mind-numbing cold. Steaming forests harboring rare creatures. Grassy plains beneath vast horizons and rich tropical seas.
And consider the relationship of the people and the wildlife of China.
To the remarkable landscaping which they live.
This is Wild China.
Beautiful scenes and beautiful voice. I'm afraid BBC will be glad to hear my next sentence because the next video clip is also from BBC, The Duchess. This story happened at the end of the 18th century and it's about the fashion icon Georgiana, who is famous for its beauty and charisma. Let's welcome our fashion icon, Mr. Chi Tiezhong, Ms. Zeng Juan, and Ms. Xie Wansheng from CO2.
All right. Georgiana.
Do you love Bess? Your Grace?
Where's all this leading?
I make no demands on him. And Bess, do you love my husband? As I do you. And so you intend to stay? William has asked that I do. Couldn't find it in your heart to refuse him. No. Then let us make a deal.
A deal?
Yes. I give you my blessing. If you will accept my feelings for Charles Grey. I didn't realize it at first. I thought that perhaps it was only a dalliance. You can make me happy.
A deal. A deal. I don't make deals. Why would I? I'm in charge of it all. No, I would call him out. I would challenge him. I'd put a bullet in his head.
William.
Be quiet. No, are you determined to make me a total laughingstock? A man who cannot sire a son, and then a cuckold?
William, Georgiana only asks what we ourselves...
Be quiet, woman! Are you his whore?
No. I can't see why you'd mind. You have Bess and three boys.
Three boys? Do you think I can make those bastards my heirs? Well, do you?
Georgiana.
Do you love Beth, your Grace?
That's always leading.
I mean, no demand on him. And Beth, do you love her husband? And then do you. So you intend to stay. William asked that too. Then they asked me, you couldn't find your heart to refuse him. No. Then they asked me a deal.
A deal?
Yes. If you accept the finish, trust me. I did realize at first I thought that perhaps it's only a dalliance. It can make me happy.
A deal. A deal. I don't make deals. What would I? I'm dropped on ball. I would call him out. I would challenge him. I put a bullet in his head.
William.
Be quiet. Are you determined to make a total laughingstock? A man who cannot say a son like a cackle?
William, I did not ask the world ourselves.
Be quiet, woman! Are you his whore?
No. But I can't divide the man. You have Beth and three boys.
Three boys? Do you see I can be lost? Bastards, my elves? Well, do you?
I'm so glad to be here to recommend the following two performances to you. It happens to every one of us that we encounter in our life a variety of trials, troubles, disappointments, and frustrations. The hero from the next performance is also faced with such a terrible circumstance. What will she do next? Let's see the next performance from Day 02, Hero. It will be performed by Wu Yanfang and Su Jianqiang. Let's welcome.
Almost as good as my Popeyes.
I think Arthur's downtown.
Yes, he is.
On your mind?
The question is, Angela, what isn't on yours? Look, it wasn't an easy decision to come. But believe it or not, I still have a shred of morality left in me somewhere. I can no longer stand by and watch him destroy you like this.
I have no idea what you're talking about. I know he's working on a project. I don't remember the details right now, but I'm sure it has to be done.
I can't push a thought into your head, Angela, but I can heal the scars.
The scars?
From all the times he's forced his thoughts, erased your memories. Each time leaves its mark, a trace of damaged tissue.
But maybe Arthur remembered to do that to me.
Arthur has betrayed you in the most heinous way possible.
How dare you?
He's gonna kill your son.
You're a liar.
I can heal the scars. You have to decide. You want to live in blind obedience. But you want to know the truth.
My pot pies.
Can you, I think Arthur's downtown.
Yes, he is.
What's on your mind?
The question is, Angela, what isn't on yours? Look, it wasn't an easy decision to come. But believe it or not, I still have a slight of morality left in me somewhere. I can no longer stand by and watch him destroy you like this.
I have no idea what you're talking about. I know he's working on a project. I don't remember the details right now, but I'm sure it has to be done.
I can't push a thought into your head, Angela. I can hear the scars.
What scars?
From all the times he's forced his thoughts, erased your memories, each time leave its mark, a trace of damaged tissue.
Arthur
is betraying you in the most heinous way possible.
How dare
you? He's gonna kill your son.
You're alive.
I can hear the scars, Angela. But you have to decide. Do you want to live in blind obedience? Or do you want to know the truth?
Yes, sir.
word. I believe that everybody loves it. Do you?
Yes!
The next performance is about a panda. And the panda has an ambitious dream. But what kind of dream does it have? Let's see the performance. Kung Fu Panda from CL2. It will be performed by Guo Hui and Chen Yuanci. Let's enjoy it.
What was that?
thinking about... noodles.
Noodles? You are thinking about noodles?
Yeah. Well, Cap, the soup is sure.
Oh, happy day! My son finally having a noodle dream! You don't know how long I've been waiting for this moment! Is it a sign I'm poor?
A sign for what?
You are almost ready to be entrusted with the secret ingredient of my secret ingredient soup. And then, fulfill your destiny and took over the restaurant. Just I took it over from my father who took it over from his father who put it in a friend in Mahjong.
But da-da-da, it was just a dream.
No, it was a dream. We are noodle fork, go run through our ways.
But did you ever want to do something else? Something besides noodles?
Actually, when I was young and crazy, I dreamed about running away and learning how to make tofu.
What did you do?
Because it was a stupid dream. Can you imagine me making tofu? Tofu. No, we all have our place in this world. Mine is here and yours is it.
I know. It's here.
No, it's a table 2,000 and turn. So we need to smile. Yeah, thank you.
Really excellent performance and a nice teamwork. It seems that our contestants are really fond of animation cartoons because next team also choose an animated film, Finding Nemo. This film was very famous. It was produced by Walt Disney and it received overwhelmingly positive reviews and won the World Academy. Let's welcome the next team, Marty and Coral, Guo Huiping and Chen Huan from CO2.
Inside the house, Carl.
Now, Corey, don't you? You'll be fine. Just get inside you right now.
Wow. Wow.
Yes, Mari. Now I see it's beautiful.
So, Coral, when you said one day ocean we, you didn't think you'd get the whole ocean, did you? Oh, yeah. A fresh caprice out here. Did you mean zero or dehydro?
My man delivered.
And it's so easy.
Because a lot of other coffees had ice on this place.
You better believe it did. I was thinking one day.
You did good. And the neighborhood is awesome.
So you do like it, don't you?
No, I do. I really do like it. But Mari, I know the job is desirable with great schools and amenity built, but do I really need so much space?
Coral! Honey, these are kids we're talking about. They deserve the best. Look. They wake up, put the lazy heads out, and they sit a wheel right by the pigeon window.
Shh, you can wake the kids.
Oh, right.
Wow, look. They are dreaming. We still have to name them.
You want to name all of them right now? Alright, we name this half Martin Junior and this half Cora Junior. Are we done?
I like Nemo.
Nemo? We name one Nemo. But I want them to be Martin Junior.
So, just in a couple of days, we're going to the parents?
Yeah. What if you don't like me?
Maureen.
No, really.
There's over 400 S. Once I'm on, they will lie you. What?
You remember our man?
Well, I try not to.
Well, I remember. Excuse me, miss. Can you check out this eagle ballet?
Maureen.
You get in close up with a wiggling.
Get away.
Here, girls. Cute is here. Why are they pretty gone? Get inside the house. No, Carl, don't. It's gonna be fun. Just get inside. You, right now.
Thank you.
Excellent performance, isn't it?
Yes.
Do you like penguin?
Yes.
Have you heard that the penguin can serve on the sea? Really? Oh, really? I just know penguin can swim, but I haven't heard about it. Okay, let's expect the performance of the seventh group from CO2. Let's welcome Zhong Liang Shen, Song Xinran, Wang Huang, Li Chengzhu. Welcome.
Oh man, you gotta try this.
No, I'm okay.
Come on, just one bite.
Alright. One bite, that's it.
Yeah, what do you think?
I mean, it's not bad, it kinda tastes like chicken.
Yep.
Sure.
Coming through! Oh crap.
Oh, I'm in love.
What are you standing here next to me for? Go talk to her, man.
No, I'm not
going
to talk to you.
Hang on, you Joe. Called you crap.
Joe.
Thanks, again.
All right, well, this is the third time you've been unconscious this week. I just don't think it's very good for your brain.
Joe,
okay.
Yeah, that was awesome. How you saved his life and all. That was just unbelievable. Really. Yeah.
You here for the surf contest? Well? I'll be watching you.
Really? You've been watching?
Well, yeah, from the lifeguard station.
Oh, you know, yeah.
It's my job.
Right. That should be right.
I'm gonna kiss her one.
Come on, Joe, you gotta
go. Dude, you were saying you were in love with him.
All right, look, he really did. He liked you, though. See ya.
Yeah, I love my job. I have an amazing job. Just this week with the contest coming up and all, it's a little crazy. You really have to be extra, extra attentive. And you have so many guys on the water, you can't miss a thing. But you know what? I have a perfect record. I've never lost anybody. Sure, there have been close calls.
No, Arnold, I turned my back to one.
Just lay some feeling on her. You know, through words, through
walking through the approach. I'm Lonnie.
You're me. Sure about that? I get real serious.
Let's not. Let's not.
Whoa. What is it?
That's it. That's Big Z Shrine. Remember?
No, not really.
Look, why is Sandy extending my tissue? Oh man.
Dude, you're gonna try this.
No, I'm okay.
Come on, just one bite.
Alright, one bite, let's eat.
Well, yeah, what do you think?
It's not bites, can't taste like chicken.
Yeah,
coming through! Oh, crap!
Oh man, I mean now.
Panic! I'm dying!
What else then you left me for? Go talk to her, man.
No, I'm not going to talk to her.
She's digging on you, she called you crap.
Please, Kim.
Alright, well, this is the third time you'll be unconscious this way, but I don't think it's very good for your brain. Okay, well.
Oh, yeah, that's also how to be stable and that's just unbelievable. Really.
You hear a folk surf contest?
Mm-hmm.
Wow, I'll be watching you.
Really? You'll be watching me?
Yeah, well, from left gun fish.
Oh, right.
What's my job?
Alright, left gun.
I'm gonna kiss her. What's going on?
Come on, Joe.
You're seeing your love.
No, I see your love.
He really thinks that he likes you, girl.
See you.
Yeah, I love my job. I have amazing job. Just this week with contest coming up and a little crazy. You really have to extra attentive. You have so many guys in the water you can't miss. You know what? I have perfect record. I've never lost anybody. But sure, there'll be close call. I took my back for one.
Just leave some feeling on her.
Touch me.
You know, through words, through what?
Walk me through the approach. And then, you're me.
You sure about that? I get real serious.
Let's not.
Whoa! What is it?
This is a bit to share. Remember?
Yeah, no, not really.
Thank you.
Thanks for Team 7. Hello, my name is Leon. I'm from CO2. The Lion King, the best animated film ever, directed by Disney. We all remember it. It's the memorable cartoon we ever met. The film had it all. It's funny, emotional, had a family drama, and above all, a great animation and songs. The voice cast is also great. My personal favorite character is Rafiki, the baboon. I can't forget the line he said to Simba. Past can hurt. As I see it, we can either run from it or learn from it. Well, welcome next teammate. Welcome.
Light of another day, and you
Didn't your mother ever tell you not to play with your food?
What do you want?
I'm here to announce that King Mufasa's on his way. So you'd better have a good excuse for missing the ceremony this morning.
Oh, now look, Sato, you made me lose my lunch.
Ha! You'll lose more than that when the king gets through with you. He's as mad as a hippo with a hernia.
Ooh, I quiver with fear.
Now, Scar, don't look at me that way.
Scar, drop him.
Impeccable timing, Your Majesty.
Why? It isn't my big brother descending from on high to mingle with the commoners.
Sarabi and I didn't see you at the presentation of Simba.
That was today? Oh, I feel simply awful. Must have slipped my mind.
Yes, well, as slippery as your mind is, as the king's brother, you should have been first in line.
Well, I was first in line until the little hairball was born.
That hairball is my son and your future king.
Oh, I shall practice my curtsy.
Don't turn your back on me, Scar.
Oh, no, Mufasa. Perhaps you shouldn't turn your back on me.
Is that a challenge?
Temper, temper. I wouldn't dream of challenging you.
Pity. Why not?
Well, as far as brains go, I got the lion's share. But when it comes to brute strength...
Well, I'm afraid I am at the shallow end of the game pool.
There's one in every family, sire. Two in mine, actually. And they always manage to ruin special occasions.
What am I going to do with him?
He'd make a very handsome throw rug.
Zazu.
And just think, whenever he gets dirty, you could take him out and beat him.
Life lawfare, is it? You see, I shall never be king. And you shall never see the night for another day. And you...
Did your mother tell you not to please your food?
What do you want?
I'm here to announce that King Mufasa's on this way. So better have a good cure for missing the ceremony this morning.
Oh, now look, Zazu, you made me lose my lunch.
You lose more than that when King gets with you. He said mad a hippo with a hernia.
Ooh, I quite will be fair.
Now, Scar, don't look at me that way. Help!
Scar?
Mm-hmm.
Drop home.
In the pet bar tent, Your Majesty.
Why, if it isn't my big brother dancing from on high to the mingle with the commoners?
Sarabi and I didn't see an apprentice of Simba.
That was today? Oh, I feel simple awful.
Yes, well, must speak my mind. Yes, well, as lonely as your man is, as the king's brother, you should be first in line.
Well, I was first in line. I needed the help, little help was born.
That help is my son, and your future king.
Oh, I should practice my fancy.
Don't turn your back on me, Scar.
Oh no, Mufasa, perhaps you shouldn't turn your back on me.
Is that a challenge?
Help! I couldn't dream of challenging you.
Pity, why not?
Well, as far as break go, I got a lunch. Welcome to the brook with fish. I swear, I'm at the ceremony of the gym pool.
That's when you want to have a family, sir. Too much, and they always meant to bring special guests.
What am I going to do with him?
He made a very handsome throw rug.
Could that do?
And that thing, whenever he gets dirty, you could take him all and beat him.
Thank you.
Wow, so great. I want to tell a story for you. Long, long ago, there was a princess who was cursed by a witch and was shut in a castle. But an ogre named Shrek overcame so many difficulties and finally saved the princess. How is their destiny? Let's pay attention to the latter story. You come the ninth group from CO3. Zhang Yanzhong, Chu Yueyan, Gao Qian, Yu Hao. Testing.
I'll admit, but thy deed is great, and thine heart is pure. I am eternally in your debt. And where would a brave knight be without his noble steed?
All right, I hope you heard that she called me a noble steed. She think I'm a steed.
The battle is won. You may remove your helmet, good sir knight.
No.
Why not?
I have helmet hair.
Please, I would look upon the face of my rescuer.
Oh, no, you wouldn't. Just.
But how will you kiss me?
What? That wasn't in the job description. Maybe it's a perk.
No, it's destiny. Oh, you must know how it goes. A princess locked in a tower and beset by a dragon is rescued by a brave knight. And then they share true love's first kiss.
With Shrek? You think, wait, you think that Shrek is your true love?
Well, yes.
You think Shrek is your true love?
What is so funny?
Let's just say I'm not your type, okay?
Of course you are. You're my rescuer. Now remove your helmet.
Look, I really don't think this is a good idea.
Just take off the helmet.
I'm not going to.
Take it off.
No!
Now!
Okay, easy. As you command, Your Highness.
You're an ogre.
You're expecting Prince Charming?
Well, yes, actually. Oh, no. This is all wrong. You're not supposed to be an ogre.
Princess, I was sent to rescue you by Lord Farquaad, okay? He's the one who wants to marry you.
Well, then why didn't he come rescue me?
Good question. You should ask him that when we get there.
But I have to be rescued by my true love. Not by some ogre and his pet.
Well, so much for noble steed.
Look, Princess, you're not making my job any easier.
Well, I'm sorry, but your job is not my problem. You can tell Lord Farquaad that if he wants to rescue me properly, I'll be waiting for him right here.
Hey, I'm no one's messenger boy, all right? I'm a delivery boy.
You wouldn't dare.
You're coming on the way. Yep, I'm right behind.
Put me down or you will suffer the consequences. This is not dignified. Put me down.
You did it. You rescued me. You're amazing. You're wonderful. At least I'm all stars, I will admit. But fear is great, and your heart is pure. I'm eternally in your debt. And where would the brave knight be without his noble steed?
Oh, happy her lad, she called me a noble steed. Just think I'm steed.
The battle is won. You may remove your helmet this night.
No.
Why not?
I have helmet hair.
Oh, please. I would set a piece on my right.
No, you wouldn't, sir.
But how will you kiss me?
What? It wasn't in job description.
Maybe it's pack.
No, it's destiny. Oh, you must know how it goes. A princess locked in tower and beset by a dragon is rescued by a brave knight. And then they share true love first kiss.
The Sheik, you think, whoa, you think Sheik is true love?
affair?
Yes.
Don't think Shake is true love. Why is so funny?
Let's just say I'm not your type, okay?
Of course you are. You're my rescuer. Now, remove the helmet.
Look, I really don't think this is a good idea.
Just take a helmet.
I'm not going to...
Take it off!
No!
Now.
Okay! Easy! As you command, Your Highness.
You're an ogre.
Oh, you were expecting Prince Charming.
Yeah. Yes, actually. This is all wrong. You're not supposed to be older.
Princess, I was sent to rescue you by Lord Farquaad, okay? He's the one who wants to marry you.
Then when did he come rescue me?
Good question. You should ask him that when we get there.
But I have to rescue by my true love. Not by some ogre and his pet.
Well, so much for the steed.
Look, Princess, you're not making my job any easier.
Oh, I'm sorry, but your job is not my problem. You can tell Lord Farquaad that if he wants to rescue me properly, I will be waiting for him right here.
Hey, I'm no one's master boy, all right? I'm the delivery boy.
You fool, dear. Oh!
You're coming, Ducky!
Yeah, I'm right behind you. Oh, thank you.
A sad story. A single mother missed her 9-year-old son. 5 months later, police found a boy who fitted the description. But when they returned the boy to the single mother, she realized that he was not her son. Why police did that? Let's find the answer. Welcome Zheng Mengda, Zhang Quanquan from CO3. Welcome.
Wait. Emotional by morning. The boy, Walter Collins, was reported as missing March 10th, 1928. We then instituted a nationwide search. On August 18th, we received a cable indicating that a boy matching this description was found in DeKalb, Illinois. Upon questioning, he admitted to being Walter Collins. We then made arrangements for him to be transported back to California.
Where Mrs. Collins told you the boy was not her son?
Yes, she denied his identity in spite of all the evidence pointing to the contrary.
But as subsequent events have demonstrated, she was correct. So, what prompted you to send her for psychological evaluation?
Whether or not this was in fact the correct boy was not relevant to my decision. Throughout this period, she acted strangely. She was often cool and aloof and unemotional, especially when confronted with the boy we found in DeKalb and in our subsequent conversation. It was because of her disturbing behavior that I submitted her for observation to the Psychopath Board of Los Angeles County General Hospital.
Just like that. You snap your fingers and an innocent woman is thrown into the psycho ward.
She wasn't
there. Every family in this state is in grave danger. When a police captain can take a woman into his office, and 5 minutes later, have her thrown into the psychopathic ward on his own authority.
She wasn't thrown. She wasn't thrown. She wasn't thrown.
What was going to happen?
She wasn't thrown. She was escorted.
Escorted, thrown. The verb doesn't matter, Captain. What does matter is that her incarceration was ordered without a warrant. I am holding a carbon copy of the affidavit of insanity. It was issued in the case of the state of California versus Christine Collins. Who signed the affidavit?
I did.
Let me see if I have this correct. A woman was thrown into the psychopathic ward without a warrant because no warrant existed. When it was finally written several days later, There was no need to sign it or to go to a judge because she was already in the asylum. Is this correct, Captain?
Technically, yes. Extraordinary steps were necessary because we were dealing with an extraordinary situation. Now, is it our fault that we were being deceived by a boy who claimed to be Walter Collins?
No.
In light of his claims and her disturbing behavior, who wouldn't begin to think that there was something the matter with her?
Because she questioned you.
No, because she wouldn't listen. Because she insisted on being obstinate. Because she tried to take matters into her own hand, best left to qualified officers. Because what civil
because
war...
Because she was fighting for the life of her son! A boy who may have still been alive while you were wasting valuable time denying you had done anything wrong. It didn't happen. That's what happened, isn't it? At some point, while all this was going on, Walter Collins was brutally murdered, along with as many as 19 other boys, at the Northcott Ranch in Wango. Is that correct, Captain?
Yes, it is.
No further questions.
The boy, Walter Collins, was reported as missing March 10, 1928. With an institute nationwide search, on August 18th, we received a cable indicating that a boy matching his descriptions was found in Decal, Illinois. Upon questioning, he admitted to being Walter Collins. We then made arrangements for him to be transported back to California.
Well, Mrs. Collins told you the boy was not her son.
Yes. She denied his identity, in spite of all the evidence pointing to the contrary.
But, as subsequent events have demonstrated, she was correct. So, what prompted you to send for psychological evaluation?
Whether or not this was in fact the correct boy was apparent to my physician. Throughout this period, she acted strangely. She was often cool and aloof and emotional, especially when confronted with the boy we find in DeKalb. And in a subsequent conversation, it was because of her disturbing behavior that I submitted her for observation to the psychopathic ward of Los Angeles County General Hospital.
Just like that, you snap your fingers and an innocent woman is thrown in a psycho ward.
She wasn't.
Every family in this state is in great danger. When a police captain can take a woman in his office and 5 minutes later, have her thrown in a psychopath's wall on his authority.
She wasn't thrown.
What was that, Captain?
She wasn't thrown, she was escorted.
Escorted, thrown. The word doesn't matter, Captain. What does matter is that her incarceration was ordered without a warrant. I'm holding a carbon copy of the affidavit of insanity that was issued in the case of the state of California versus Clifton Collins. Who signed it, David?
I did.
Well, now let me see if I have this correct. A woman was thrown in a psychopath's wall without a warrant because no warrant existed. And when it was finally written 7 days later, there was no need to sign it or to go to a judge because she was already in the asylum. Is this correct, Captain?
Technically, yes. Extraordinary steps were necessary because we were dealing with an extraordinary situation. Now, is it our fault that we were being deceived by a boy who claimed to be Walter Collins? No. In Ivy's claims and her disturbing behavior, who would begin to think that there was something the matter with her?
Because she questioned you.
No, because she would listen. Because she insists on being obstinate. Because she tried to take matters in her own hand, best left qualified officer. Because once you were disobedient,
sir. Why for the life of a son? A boy who may still be alive while you're wasting valuable time denying her that anything wrong. And in the end, that's what happened, isn't it? At some point, while all this was going on, Walter Collins was brutally murdered.
along with as many men as 19 other boys, at no small range in Whiteville. Is that correct, Captain?
Yes, it is.
No further questions.
Thank you.
Wow, thank you for the performance. And now, let me introduce myself. I am from AO302. My name is Daniel. Today is my honor to stand here and be the host. And ladies and gentlemen, I want to ask you some questions. Have you ever had a dream to be a princess?
Yes.
And have you ever been into a wonderland called Genovia? Oh, if you have never been there, it doesn't matter. And as we all know, all of the people also like to keep their secret into their diary books. And what about a princess? And the following competitors will lead us to appreciate a princess. And we will find out what a lovely princess she is. And please welcome the competitor from CO3, Zhao Xin and Luo Lingqiong.
Yes, you can.
No, I can't believe that you hung me up. After all I did for you, you know, I kept your loyal secret, and do you know how hard it is to have a capital and keep a secret?
You didn't keep a secret from me. How dirty you thought my being princess was. Well, congratulations, and you're gonna wish I'm not a princess.
You're not?
No.
But I want you to be.
What?
I didn't mean it, just the green monster of jealousy came out because you were Miss Barbara, and I thought I was losing my best friend, so I got angry and upset and hurt. And I told you, I need an attitude adjustment. But the truth is, you being a princess is kind of miracle.
Oh, no. What? Miracle is a nightmare.
No, think about it. I just found out that my cable show only reaches 12 people. Wanting to rock the world, but have the power like me, now that's a nightmare. But you... I mean...
Okay, what is so wow?
Wow is having the power to affect change, make people listen. How many teenagers have that power? What more of miracle do you want?
Well, we'll just have to find a different miracle. No more just different. Listen. Tomorrow night is Genovia Independence Day Ball, and to make up for my missing your cable show, I'm inviting you. I hope you forgive me, and I hope you come.
But what? Why where?
Yeah! I don't know, but you know, it doesn't really matter. I just have you on the bottom top!
Thanks, and you can be a princess.
No, I can't.
Yes, you can.
Thank you.
Wow, our contestants all performed very well.
Yes, I have to say, you are all awesome actors. I'm afraid now it's hard for our judges to decide who will be the final winners. So let's give them some time to have a discussion.
Okay, we have invited a special guest who has one personal honorable mentioned by Darwin the Kung Fu Panda in pronunciation and intonation contest.
Another Kung Fu Panda. Aha! I like noodles.
So you are not the real Kung Fu Panda.
I was a little bit affected by our awesome actors. So now, let's welcome our special guest performer, Daniel from AO3.
Get out there alive. I mean, I didn't actually say that, but I thought it in my mind. If it could read my mind, it would say, what? What up? Hope you like it.
This is really good.
No, come on, it's trying to dance secret ingredient soup. He actually knows secret.
What are you talking about? This is amazing.
Wow, you're really good at cooking.
Tigers, you got to try this. It is said that the real dragon warrior is not as fast as the panda.
I guess nobody doesn't know it's a dragon warrior yet, huh? I need a lot more to do, and the universe do. What?
Oh, nothing, Master Shifu. You will never be the dragon warrior unless you lose 500 pounds and brush your teeth. What's the noise you're making? Laughter? I never heard it. Work hard, Panda. Maybe someday you will have years of
That's good. Yes, it's not working for you. I thought they were pretty good.
It's Shifu. Of course, Shifu. What do you think I'm doing? Master Shifu.
Do you think this is funny? Pilot has escaped from prison and you are acting like children. He's coming from the dragon's brood and you are the only one who can stop him. And I just think you got no sense of humor. I'm gonna stop.
What? Are you serious?
I'm gonna.
Oh, Master Wu Gui will stop him. He did it before. He will do it again. Wu Gui cannot. Not anymore. Our only hope is the dragon warrior.
The panda?
Yes, the panda.
Please, Master, let us stop Tai Lung. It's what you train us for.
No, it's not your destiny to defeat Tai Lung. It's his.
Where did he go?
You cannot live. A real warrior never quits. Watch me.
Come on, how am I supposed to beat Tai Lung?
I can't even beat him to the stairs.
You will beat him because you are the dragon warrior.
Oh, you don't believe that. Oh, you never believed that. For the first time I got here, you even tried to get rid of me.
I was, but now I ask you to trust me as I come to trust in mine.
You're not my master, and I am not a dragon warrior.
Don't want to quit. You know I'm trying to get rid of you, yet you stay?
Yet, I stay?
I stay, because every time I throw a brick at my head, I'll say that I smell, it hurts. But it could never hurt more than it did every day of my life just being me. I stay because I thought if anyone could change me, could make me, not me, it was you, the greatest kung fu teacher in all of China.
But I can change you. I can turn you into the dragon warrior. And I will.
Come on, Tai Lung is on his way here right now. And even if it takes him hundreds of years, how are you gonna change this into the dragon warrior, huh? How? How? How?
I don't know.
You all did a good job, and our honorable judge, Michael, will give us a recommendation, or he will give all our contestants some suggestions and advices, and he will tell us his true feeling, okay?
Good evening, everyone. It's really nice to see you. I've seen some of my students here. I've enjoyed your performance tonight. I think your acting is really good. And I can see that you put a lot of work into learning your lines. You did a really good job with it. I'm very impressed by all of your ability and your enthusiasm and your acting. I encourage you to use these films as a way to practice your English. So I just wanted to say that you should keep doing it and try to use the films to improve your pronunciation and really try to imitate the films as closely as you can. At a certain level of your performance, where you are putting some of your emotion into your performance, that's very good. I think you're ready to take your time to match your intonation and your timing a little bit better to the lines. Some of the lines are very quick, but there is kind of a natural tendency to go a little bit too fast. So I just suggest that you take a little bit more time in your delivery, how you give your lines, and especially when you're practicing by yourself, you can practice the lines very slowly. Even if the scene requires that you speak them quickly, you can practice them slowly to try to get the proper meaning into everything that you're saying. So that's really your kind of your next step in your acting and your dubbing. That's where you should go from here. But thank you very much. I'm really pleased to be here, and I've enjoyed it a lot. This was a lot of fun for me to watch all these different scenes from the movies. There's some movies here that I wasn't familiar with, and so I'm really glad to get a chance to watch them and to see you act them out. So thank you very much. I really enjoyed it.
After our judges discussion, the exciting moment is coming.
Boys and girls, which is your favorite team?
Which is your favorite team?
Do you have choice?
We have three teams in third prize. The first team, they are from CO2, Surf Up.
Congratulations.
And the second team is from CO3, Track.
Congratulations.
And the third team is from CO2, Hero. Congratulations. And let's welcome our teachers, Miss Li Yi, Ms. He Jie, Mr. Li Yi, Ms. He Jie, to award the third prize winners.
Come on.
So welcome all the